everyone and welcome back my dear students. In our last video we discussed about inverse trigonometric functions, domain, range and how to find the principal value of the given inverse trigonometric function. In this video I am going to discuss about some properties of inverse trigonometric functions. How to prove, these are all the properties of inverse trigonometric functions. How to prove these inverse trigonometric functions we will discuss in this video. Then first we have to know what are the properties. The first property is sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse of x, and cos inverse of 1 by x is secant inverse of x. Third one is tan inverse of 1 by x is equal to cot inverse of x, which means for sine, cos and tan, 1 by sine inverse of 1 by x, cos inverse of 1 by x and tan inverse of 1 by x become the corresponding to inverse trigonometric function, that is sine become cosecant, cos become secant and tan become cot. And next one is sine inverse of minus x is become minus sine inverse of x, tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse of x, cosecant inverse of minus x is equal to minus cosecant inverse of x. Observe that for sine, tan and cosecant, minus of that given function is equal to minus into the given inverse trigonometric function only for sine, tan and cosecant. Then come to the next one, cos inverse of minus x, it become 5 minus cos inverse of x, and secant inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus secant inverse of x. Similarly, cot inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cot inverse of x, which means for cos, secant and cot, cos minus of that function is equal to pi minus of the given function. You have to remember these properties. Now we go how to prove these properties one by one. First one, sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse of x. We have to prove that sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse of x. In the first step, put cosecant inverse of x is equal to y. In the first step, put the RHS is the cosecant inverse of x is equal to y. Then this cosecant inverse is shifted to this side. Then when shifted to this side, cosecant inverse become cosecant x. So this implies cosecant inverse go to this side, it becomes so x, right? As it is, cosecant come to this side, it becomes cosecant y. So in the first step we put the RHS as y. In the next step we shift this cosecant inverse to right side, then it become cosecant y. In the next step, take reciprocal. The reciprocal means, so x becomes 1 by x. So here also cosecant y, it becomes 1 by cosecant y. We already know that 1 by cosecant is sine. So 1 by cosecant y is equal to what? Sine y. So we have 1 by x is equal to sine y. So in the next step, shift this sine into this. If this side, it becomes sine inverse. So when come to this side, it becomes sine inverse, right? 1 by x as it is equal to y. So in this step, I replace or shift this sine into this side. So it becomes sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to y as it is. Then come to this one, in this point. So what is the value of y? Y means cosecant inverse of x. So sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to y means cosecant inverse of x. This is our required property. So sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse of x. So I repeat once again, in the first step, put the cosecant inverse of x as y. Then the next step, shift this cosecant inverse to this side, then it becomes cosecant y. Then take reciprocal. So 1 by cosecant means sine. Then again shift this sine to this side, it becomes sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to y. Then put the value of y, that is cosecant inverse of x, we get the required property. So in the same way, I prove this one, you have to prove another two. You have to follow the same procedure. Then we get cos inverse of 1 by x secant inverse of x and tan inverse of 1 by x is equal to cot inverse of x. You have to follow the same procedure. Okay. Then in the next I have to prove, I'm going to prove 4, 5 and 6. In that I take property 5th one, that is tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse of x. So here I want to prove tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse of x. See, in this proof also, first put tan inverse of minus x as y. Here I take this one, I put this one as y. In the next step, so shift this tan inverse to this side, so it becomes tan. So write minus x as it is equal to, when this comes to this side, it becomes tan y. So multiply minus on both sides. So when you multiply here minus, again here also minus, minus into minus become plus. So it become plus x. So here minus tan y. So we know that tan minus theta is equal to minus tan theta. So here we have minus tan y. So this can be written as tan of minus y. So now shift this tan to here. So it becomes tan inverse of x is equal to minus y. Then what is the value of y? Y is equal to tan inverse of minus x. So tan inverse of x is equal to what? Minus y means tan inverse of minus, sorry, tan inverse of minus x. The value of y is tan inverse of minus x. Again multiplied negative on both sides. So it becomes minus tan inverse of x is equal to tan inverse of minus x, or tan inverse of minus x is equal to what? Minus tan inverse of x. So observe that in the first step, I put tan inverse of minus x as y, and I replace tan inverse to this side, it becomes tan, and multiply it minus on both the sides. So here we get positive and here we get negative. So we know that tan of minus theta is minus tan theta. So minus tan y can be written as tan of minus y. Again shift this tan to here, it becomes tan inverse of x is equal to minus y. So I write minus as it is, then the value of y. Y is tan inverse of minus x. Okay, and again multiply minus on both the sides, it becomes negative, here it becomes positive. So we get tan minus tan inverse of x is equal to tan inverse of minus x, or so tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse of x. So property 4, 5, 6. So you have to follow the same procedure. I prove this one. So another two properties you have to solve yourself. You have to prove yourself. So next property, 7, 8, 9. So 7th one, what is the property? That is cos inverse of minus x. So cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. So we have to prove that cos inverse of minus x and is equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. So here also in the first step, put cos inverse of minus x as y. In the next step, obviously shift this one. So cos inverse become, so we write minus x as it is, and cos inverse will come to this side, it becomes cos y. In the next step, multiply minus on both sides. So here it becomes positive. So here it is minus cos y. But here we can't write this as cos of minus y, because we know that cos of minus theta is equal to plus cos theta. So here we can't write like this. So what we have to do? So we also know that the range and principal branch value of inverse trigonometry function in our last video. And when cos become negative, so we know that the branch or range of cos is 0 to pi. So this can be written as, when cos is negative, it is negative in second quadrant. So this can be written as cos of pi minus y. So cos of pi y minus means it is second quadrant. In second quadrant, cos is negative. So cos of pi minus y is equal to minus cos y. So that's why minus cos y can be written as cos of pi minus y. So here write x as it is. In the next step, so shift this cos to here. So it becomes cos inverse of x is equal to here we have pi minus y. Then replace the value of y. That is, what is the value of y? Y is cos inverse of minus x. Cos inverse of minus x. Here write cos inverse of x as it is. We have to prove that cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. So when you come to this side, this comes to this side and this comes to this side. So cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. This is our required property. I repeat once again. So we have to prove that cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. So further, put cos inverse of minus x as y. In the next step, shift this cos inverse to here, it becomes cos. So write minus x as it is equal to, when this comes to this side, it becomes cos y. In the next step, multiply negative sign on both sides. So x is equal to, we get minus cos y. Minus cos y can be written as cos of pi minus y. So in the next step, shift this cos to here, it becomes cos inverse. So cos inverse of x is equal to pi minus y. Then replace the value of y. What is the value of y? Y is cos inverse of minus x. Or it can be written as, this come to here, it becomes cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi. When this come to here, plus cos inverse of x becomes minus cos inverse of x. So in this, follow the same procedure for secant inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus secant inverse of x, and cot inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cot inverse of x. These are all properties of inverse trigonometry function. It is very easy. You have to know the steps. So next, we still have some more properties to prove. So we prove one by one. The next property is sine inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. We have to prove that sine inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. So for this, put sine inverse of x is equal to y. I take it as sine inverse of x as y. Again, obviously in the next step, write x as it is. Sine inverse when goes to this side, it becomes sine y. Okay, in the next step, observe that sine y can be written as cos pi by 2 minus y. So we already know that in your previous year, so for 90 degree and for 270, cos becomes sine, sine becomes cos. Similarly, cosecant becomes secant, secant becomes cosecant. And also tan becomes cot and cot becomes tan, only for pi by 2 and for 270 degree. So sine y can be written as cos pi by 2 minus y. So cos pi by 2 means for pi by 2, cos becomes sine. So again it becomes sine y. So sine y can be written as cos pi by 2 minus y. So in the next step, shift this cos to here, it becomes cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus y. So cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus, what is the value of y? Y means sine inverse of x. So sine inverse of x. Then if this comes to here, minus sine inverse x become plus sine inverse of x. So this implies sine inverse of x plus, here we have cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. I repeat once again, here we have to prove that sine inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. In the first step, I put sine inverse of x as y. I shift sine inverse to this side, becomes sine y. In the next step, this is the main step. So sine y can be written as cos of pi by 2 minus y. So in the next step, cos shifted to this side, it becomes cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus y. Then replace the value of y, that is sine inverse of x. Again shift this minus inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Similarly, we have another property, that is tan inverse of x plus cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. So, this is similar properties. Here, sin inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Here, we have tan inverse of x plus cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. So, follow the same procedure. In the first step, put tan inverse of x as y. Then, x become tan y. Here, tan can be written as cot of pi by 2 minus y. Already, I said that for pi by 2, tan become cot. So, tan y can be written as cot of pi by 2 minus y. Again, shift cot this side, which become cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus y. So, cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus, what is the value of y? Y is tan inverse of x. So, when come to this side, it becomes tan inverse of x plus cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. So, both are same. We have to follow the same step. Another one property is also there, that is secant. Secant inverse of x plus cosecant inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. So, for this also you have to follow the same procedure. So, then move on to the next properties. These are all very simple properties. It will be asking for 2 or 3 marks in your examination. So, next one, tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus x into y. This is very, very important property. Using this property, later we have to prove some problems also. So, what is the property? Tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So, for this, you have to know one trigonometry formula, that is tan a plus b. What is the formula for tan a plus b? Tan of a plus b is equal to tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. This is the trigonometry formula for tan of a plus b is equal to tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. Similarly, we have tan a minus b, that is equal to tan a minus tan b divided by 1 plus tan a into tan b. So, observe that when here positive, here negative. But when here a minus b is there, tan a minus tan b divided by 1 plus tan a into tan b. This is the standard formula. So, when prove this one, for this, in the first step, put tan inverse of x as a. I put this first term, which is tan inverse of x as y, and also tan inverse of y as b. So this implies when tan inverse goes to this side, it becomes tan. So x is equal to what? Tan a. Tan inverse of x is equal to a, that implies x is equal to tan a. Similarly, tan inverse of y is equal to b. Y is equal to what? Tan b. Okay, we know that, we already know that the formula, that is tan of a plus b, I use this one, is equal to what? Tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. Okay, this is, we know the formula. So, this implies, so tan a plus b, tan a, what is the value of tan a? Tan a means x plus tan b. What is the value of tan b here? y divided by 1 minus tan a means x into tan b means y. So, observe that here, I just give y divided by 1 minus xy. So now substitute the value of a. What is a? A is tan inverse of x plus b means tan inverse of y. Tan inverse of y is equal to what? Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So this is our required property. Tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to what? Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. For this, I put tan inverse of x as a and tan inverse of y as b. So it becomes x is equal to tan a and y is equal to tan b. So next, this is the standard formula, which is tan of a plus b is tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. In the next step, we place the values tan a means x plus tan b means y divided by 1 minus tan a is x, tan b is y. In the next step, we place this tan here, it becomes tan inverse. Then again, we place the values of a and b, that is tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. We have another property, that is tan inverse of x minus tan inverse of y is equal to what? Tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. For this you have to follow the same procedure, but you have to use this formula. In the place of tan a plus b, you have to use tan a minus b, then you get the required property. It is very important, that is tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy, and also tan inverse of x minus tan inverse of y is equal to what? Tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. You have to remember these two formulas because we use later to solve some problems. Okay, so next move on to the some other properties. That is sine inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square is equal to 2 sine inverse of x. So prove that sine inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square is equal to 2 sine inverse of x. We have to prove this one. How? So in the next step, first step, put sine inverse of x as theta. Here, sine inverse of x is equal to theta. So similarly, it becomes what? X is equal to sine theta. Okay, this is the first step. In the next step, you have to prove this one right. So consider LHS. So consider this one, that is sine inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square. Now sine inverse of 2 into x, x means what here? Sine theta. So it means sine theta square root of 1 minus x square. X means sine theta, x square means sine square theta. That is sine square theta. I just replace the value of x here. In the next step, sine inverse of 2 into sine theta square root of. So you have to remember the identities formulas of trigonometric functions here. 1 minus sine square theta. 1 minus sine square theta is equal to cos square theta. This is the formula. So I replace 1 minus sine square means cos square theta. You have to study all of this identity in your previous year. So just in a deeper gera pokadilla. So 1 minus sine square means cos square. In the next step, the square root and this square get cancelled. So sine inverse of 2 sine theta. So square gets cancelled, it becomes cos theta. You also remember that 2 sine theta into cos theta means what? So sine 2 theta. What is the formula for sine 2 theta? 2 sine theta into cos theta. So sine theta, 2 into sine theta into cos theta becomes sine inverse of sine 2 theta. For this, formula is sine 2 theta. So here then sine inverse and sine become cancelled. First before going to this, you have to know sine inverse of x, sine inverse of sine x is also x. Similarly, sine inverse of x is also x. So because sine inverse and sine get cancelled, here also sine and sine inverse get cancelled. The remaining is x. So using that one, sine inverse into sine of 2 theta, sine inverse and sine get cancelled. The remaining is 2 theta. 2 into what is the value of theta? Theta means sine inverse of x. 2 into sine inverse of x. This is our RHS, right? So we have to prove sine inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square is equal to 2 sine inverse of x. So we prove this one. So we still have, so I know that, I hope you already understand. So in the next, we still have some more properties to prove. So using the already proved sine inverse of x plus tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Using that formula, we have to prove some more problems. So we discussed in my next video. Thank you.